Okay, so here's where we're at. These were these, bam. I got mirror images of both of these, both of my back rest insert, and this is my seat, pin seat inserts, okay? And I got this out of that. So there you go. We're gonna kick this aside now and move on to our boxing. Okay, so there's that. I got two of those off of this, off of my old cover, and that's what I wanted to do with this. I wanted to use the existing old cover, and I drew my, you know, my design on there, and here I am working off of that, you know. Just a time saver, and it can be done. There's various ways of doing this. This is the quickest way for me, for what I'm doing here. Any inconsistencies, I'm not gonna mind. I'm always gonna stitch straight and cut straight. Okay, I wanted to just show this real quick. These are my marks that I put in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there's this is why we do those, so we can match it. So this piece is gonna get stitched to here. Okay, and as you can see, all those are matching. Okay. They'll have to be stretched into place sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
But they all go on there, so that'll go there. Just continue cutting. This is our pattern that we cut out. So bam, I traced it out. Okay. Put all my notches in there, my indicators, and then I did a mirror image, flipped it up here. Because I want a mirror image, so I went upside down. Put all my traces back in there. This is our center. Started there. Again, leaving my half inch allowance all the way around and splitting this right in half. Fold it over and do a mirror image of the same piece because I got a wide center. This is my center again. So there's that. I'll cut that out. And this is the outer ends of the seat. I started with this one here. Left my half inch allowance, cut it out, and used it for this pattern. So I'm gonna cut that out, scrim all this. There's that one. There's my other piece off my seat. This was the center, and this is the bottom of the seat. On this one, I made my own adjustments on here. I have all my notches. I measured it out. The overall should be about 5 inches, so I measured that out. I ran my straight edge across. I put a small taper here on the end because I noticed that the last person that made this cover didn't allow for the frame on the seat, so I cut that, I notched it out so it fits nice. Again, I left my half inch allowance all the way around. So this one will be, I'm gonna make a mirror image of this one, just like I did that, just like I did this. These two will be stitched together, and that's where we're at right now. Okay, let's see what this looks like. I'm gonna put the light on it so you guys can see this. This is a very nice seam. That's what my top stitch looked like. So if you guys remember, before we had a welt there. Well, this is the outside of my bench seat. This is the top, and that's the side. Okay, so this thing's starting to come together now. But see, look at this French seam. Look how nice that looks. Okay, that is a really nice stitch that will really enhance your upholstery work. Instead of a no welt, you got a French seam there now. So here's what this is going to start to look like. It's going to start to look like this. And this will roll around the front of the seat. Okay. Something like that. Okay, so I'll show you guys some more stuff as we go. There it is. Okay. And then again, if you guys recall, I'm gonna do a French seam on 1, 2, 3, 4 places, and then there's going to be a French seam on the outer two pieces, okay? I think we're going to have a nice bench seat here. Here we go. And these are going to go in here. This is my longer bed and this one here. So as you can see, my pieces will all match, allowing half-inch allowance all the way around. There's those. There's my center mark. Everything's going to be nice. So that's going to be stitched right in there. That one's going to be stitched right in there. Okay, we got our French seam out here, French seam. And then the only thing we have to work on is the bottom section that wraps around the underneath and the two sides, which most likely you're going to see this much of it. It'll be flipped like this by the time it's done. So you'll be able to see that. This will be basically what you're looking at. Okay, so that's where we're at. Okay, so this is our bench seat we're working on now. I'm just gonna put everything together now. I'm ready to join this thing and get this thing done. Here's all my pieces. I got all my indicators. They're all gonna match, okay? And then these are our bench seat ends, the boxing in the end, okay? So we already did our French seam on each of these, okay? I'm gonna start joining these together. I'm gonna join our centers together, which is our insert, our pleated inserts, to the inner boxing there, and then I'm gonna put the outsides on it, and this is the back of the seat. This will be across back here, and all these should match up in the end, okay? I'm just gonna start joining it now. I am gonna stitch these ends together so it doesn't move on me, and then we'll clean it up and we'll show you what it looks like on the bench seat. So that's what this is starting to look like. This is called a waterfall. This is a bench seat, and that's called a waterfall, okay? So I'm gonna throw this off, and we're gonna continue to work on our frame. So this will go on here, okay? Throw that on there. And then we got a few new springs because we had some missing. Okay. And I'm probably going to throw some burlap on here. Black it out first. And I'm going to wrap up this bench seat pretty soon here. Then I'll finish up the backrest. Okay. Okay, so we got our base done. We got new springs, new base, new scrim, steamed the foam. Now let's finish fitting our seat cover. And let's get this thing done. Okay, so we stitched all our edging stuff on here. And this is what's gonna lock the seat in place. Stitched all the way around. We got it notched where we need it. Roll when we need it. So now, let's install this thing and move along. Put this thing on this back. This is what the front looks like. And the underneath is super clean. I have no complaints about the way this one turned out. Tight fit. We fixed all this stuff. All match. Before I hot-ring them on. So I just wanted to make sure that my lines are perfectly matching right here. So I'm going to just start hot-ringing it. Okay, so old pattern. Backboard, new one, lined it up, trimmed it off with some cutters. Now I'm gonna punch out my holes for our plastic clips to hold it together. Okay, that concludes our seat cover. It's all done, front's back. Front, back, bottom, underneath. It's all done. Solid. she left a long time. We made the back cover out of black paddle boarding. We call that wetboard. And it was all done with all, with this. This is where I laid all my map bit. This is the back seat. I cut them in half. This is my center line. This is my center line on the seat. This is my center line on the backrest. And I kind of drew a map and cut it all out and added half inch allowance all the way around. This is the auto, that's the bottom. This is the seat. Again, I just cut them all out and left half inch allowance all the way around. And from that, ended up with this.